Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or in the app for a free one-week trial. Just $4.99 a month for your all-access pass. Playing now on Fandor is G-Men versus the Dragon. After Japanese spies from the Black Dragon Society infiltrate United States borders, federal agent Rex Bennett is enlisted by the government to capture them. Bennett teams up with British Special Agent Vivian Marsh and Chinese Special Agent Chang Xing to stop them and help win the war.
Hey, welcome back to the Fandor Podcast. We are about to start part two with, in my opinion, legendary coach, the one, the great Jim Harbaugh. Jim, thank you for being here.
Great to be here. Thanks for having me.
Oh my God, it's an honor. First of all, thank you, Chris, for hooking all this up. You're a man of many talents. All right, so in the first segment, we heard Jim's top seven sports films of all time.
What are yours?
Oh, wow. Let me think. Okay, so you did mention one that I love so much. You did mention Hoosiers, and that was the one I was going to mention as well. Mine is actually on this list that I'm about to run down with you guys, because we're about to go through about 30 or 40 films. And I'll throw on mine towards the end. So I'm just going to go to you and Chris and maybe even Bryn and just say, what do you think? So let's start with a kind of low hanging fruit, Jerry Maguire. Is that a good sports film?
That's a real good sports film. Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. The agent relationship with the wide receiver football player. I mean, that's a good one.
Okay. Show me the money.
Show me the money.
All right. Any given Sunday.
A lot of cameos too. A lot of NFL player cameos. Lee Steinberg.
Yep. Yeah.
Probably loosely based on Lee.
Yeah, very much so.
Who I know well. I mean, cool stuff.
Any given Sunday.
Really good. Really good, I thought, as well. I mean, some good hard-hitting football scenes. And
is it accurate?
A little exaggerated. A little exaggerated in that, like, everything happens that can happen in one, like, season or one week.
Right.
Kind of like The Program, if you remember that one, had the Boz and some other guys. It's sure. Like anything that could possibly happen over a 10-year period happens in, you know, in a couple weeks or two. Yeah.
How about this is a movie I'm unfamiliar with. You mentioned it to me yesterday, Ice Castles.
No, I think that was my wife, Sarah.
Oh, okay.
I'm not familiar with that.
You know Ice Castles?
I do.
What's it about?
So it was Blind Skater, if I remember correctly.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. It was good. I mean, I remember seeing it all over video stores when I was growing up, and I think I watched it once.
Blades of Glory?
Blades of Glory. That was more my speed.
That's pretty darn good.
Yeah.
Okay. Blades of Glory, giving that a thumbs up. How about Tin Cup?
That's a classic. Yeah. Kevin Costner again,
Rene Russo.
Rene Russo. That's tremendous.
Okay, that was a good one. All right, let's go to D.B. Sweeney.
Yeah, D.B.
That's your boy.
We used to kind of hang out back in the 80s.
Now, remind me what movie he's in that you love?
Eight Men Out.
Which
is, good baseball about the John Chicago
Sales,
Black Sox.
Fantastic movie, with Ray Liotta and a bunch of others. And,
Then D.B. was in a skating movie. McClam, I can't think of what the name of it was.
I'll look it up while you answer this next one. This is a movie that you're not a fan of that I actually really like. Rudy.
Yeah.
Why don't you like Rudy?
It's nothing not to like about Rudy. It's not one of my favorites.
Yeah, it didn't touch
you. Is it because it's Notre Dame?
Maybe. Could possibly be. Some bearing on it.
I'm looking at D.B. Sweeney movies. There's The Cutting Edge.
Cutting Edge was the skating movie, yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So he's an ice skater in that, huh?
Yeah.
This guy can do everything.
Yeah, and I played in some charity baseball games with him. Nice. He's a good athlete, really. He was really good in that role, Eight Men Out.
When was the last time you guys talked?
In, like, early 90s.
Oh, okay. Man. You guys have you need to have a reunion.
There we go.
Cool guy.
Yeah. You and DB. Okay, so let's keep going here. What about Gus?
Is that about a horse that kicks field goals?
Yes.
Donkey. That's good.
Did you like that's a Don Knotts Ed Asner movie?
Yeah, you gotta like anything with Don Knotts. Anything with Don Knotts and Ed Asner. I remember that as being good. Trying to think of the other. There's a couple. kid movies with the dog. Remember the golden retriever that would
Air Bud.
Air Bud. Air Bud. Yeah, that was a good movie.
You like that too?
I like that, that one.
Can you?
I like Little Giants better.
Okay.
With Ed O'Neill.
Yeah.
That's a tremendous good football movie.
Is there any sports movie that you don't like? Because you seem to love everything.
There's got to be.
How about the Mighty Ducks? Do you like that?
Okay.
Yeah, I could never get excited about the Mighty Ducks.
Yeah. Like, okay.
Emilio Estevez sort of in his comeback role.
I'd prefer Slapshot.
Yeah.
Over Mighty Ducks.
I preferred him in Repo Man to, the Mighty Ducks role.
Did you ever see a film with Rodney Dangerfield?
You ever see Slapshot?
Did you ever see a movie with
Old School? Back to School?
Back to School. That was.
He's a diver. You could probably put that in. That's
that good. That would work.
Yeah. Rodney's a legend.
Rodney Dangerfield is, yes.
Was that Back to School?
Back to School was, yeah.
He played a soccer coach in a movie called Ladybug. Did you ever see that?
I didn't.
Oh, boy.
Okay. I'm going to go watch it.
No, though, don't go watch. Come on.
Rodney Dangerfield's the man. Yeah. Get no respect.
Did you ever see Caddyshack?
Oh, yeah.
Is that considered a great?
Gosh, you got to put that up there with the greats of all time. There's no doubt.
Okay. All right, let's keep going back to our list. We're going to change sports here. What about Seabiscuit?
That's a great one. Another heartwarming.
I read the book. I never saw the movie.
It's Tobey Maguire, I think.
Yeah, I never saw the movie.
Yeah, Seabiscuit. I mean, there's some great analogies there. You know, coming down the home stretch. You know, the blinders are on, and then I think the Seabiscuit coming thundering down the home stretch, and then gets a look at the other horse's eye, and then
takes off.
Yeah,
that's beautiful.
Let's go.
What about Chariots of Fire?
Yeah, it's really good. I have not really seen that one all the way through. I can never get through that whole movie. I don't want Academy Award.
I've seen it. I liked it fine. You know, the music is what sticks with everyone.
Yeah, the music.
Mm-hmm. Bryn, you're a world-class martial artist, world champion in a field of Kuksulwan,
sure,
Korean martial arts.
Uh-huh. That's a good question. Okay, let's compare the two. You got Chariots of Fire. How many times? Chris said he's seen Chariots of Fire once. I think I've seen it probably once all the way through. How many times have you seen Talladega Nights compared to how many times?
Like six, eight.
Six or eight. Yeah.
So I showed it to my kids the other day for the first time. Yeah.
Bryn, I was going to ask you, is there a great martial arts movie?
I don't know, man. What do you think? Karate Kid or?
Karate Kid always comes up. But the Bruce Lee movies are so much better.
The Bruce Lee ones. Yeah. Oh, the new ones are Ip Man. You know Ip Man?
Yeah.
That guy.
You know Ip Man? I haven't seen that.
Yeah. It's all about Wing Chun, the hands.
Okay.
It's amazing. Huh.
Yeah. I'll have to
check that out.
Yeah, it's big in China.
Yeah.
Can we bring Kung Fu in?
Yeah.
David Carradine from the 70s.
Uh-huh. Did you watch that? Series. He's too young.
I love it.
We were talking about that.
Rewatch it if you haven't watched that. Three seasons
of it. Yeah.
Of Kung Fu walking the earth like Kane.
All right, let's.
got the stance and the
You mentioned a movie yesterday that I don't think is a sports movie. I want to debate this a little bit. Heaven Can Wait.
Yeah, that was a sports movie.
Warren Beatty
plays quarterback for the Rams.
And what happens in the plot of the film?
He dies.
Right.
He dies. He goes to heaven. Then he comes back, and I can't remember exactly.
So is this the one where George Burns was God?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
I'm just wondering, that seems more like a movie about heaven. Is it really sports?
He was playing for the Rams.
All right. Well, I guess you're right.
That's true. Yeah.
I mean, growing up, any movie about sports, I wanted to see.
Yeah.
If there's anything in it. Paper Lion, George Plimpton.
Yeah.
That was an awesome one.
That was
one,
a good one.
You know?
I'll
tell you another classic.
Here we go.
Fear Strikes Out, the Jimmy Pearsall story.
Yep.
What about Space Jam?
Good.
You like that?
That's
one?
Excellent.
Man,
excellent.
Let me tell you something. If you have a movie coming out, have Jim Harbaugh review it. Yeah. He loves everything.
I believe I can fly. That's inspiring.
R. Kelly's had his troubles since we're not allowed to play that anymore.
Right.
But
you can play a song?
But the new LeBron James Space Jam comes out, I think, in just a couple of months. And so we'll see how this all hangs together. The continuing adventures of Lola Bunny.
Mm-hmm.
You mentioned another movie yesterday that is a little controversial in terms of sports films. Gladiator. Is that a sports movie?
Yes, that's a. I mean, you got may have to move that to number one because that's.
it is incredible.
It's a sport. I mean,
strength and honor.
Is it?
They are athletes.
They're in the Coliseum. I mean, that's competing. the original sport, gladiators.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You know, football takes its name from gladiators. Yeah. Gridiron Gladiators.
Chris brought up a movie yesterday. I don't know if it's a sports movie. Your wife says it is. It's a movie you guys watched last night, Top Gun. Is that a sports film because of the volleyball scene? Yes or no?
I love Top Gun, but I can't call that a sports movie.
No, it's not a sports movie. Okay. I think we're in full agreement there.
But a classic.
But absolutely a classic.
And you also mentioned Ace Ventura. Now, is that a sports movie?
Dan Marino's in it, and
it's all about missing a kick in the Super Bowl. Yeah. Like, you know,
Ray Finkel.
That's totally a sports movie.
Was it wide left or wide right? I know the laces.
I mean, laces out was the thing.
Laces in or out?
Yeah. I think he was wide left, if I remember correctly. But we may have to watch it again. Just
on the note of Top Gun, though, I mean, aren't they making video games a sport now? Right? So if those are sports, wouldn't you consider flying an airplane a sport, especially in their... at their caliber. So
we'll have some League
That's
of Legends.
That's a valid argument. Valid argument.
Okay. Who's a worse actor, Dan Marino or Brett Favre?
I mean, I hate to compare those. I mean, two of the all-time great quarterbacks.
Chris, I don't. I know.
Look,
you.
Brett Favre and Something About Mary was truly, truly awful. Okay. Whereas Dan Marino in Ace Ventura and some of the other things that he showed up in has been passable. So that's my read on it. but Favre was almost supposed to be awful in that role. You know, Mary, you're the only one for me.
Remember that, Jim? Come on.
Yeah, they didn't write. They didn't give him good material. There.
They certainly didn't give him good material. And I think that was somewhat deliberate. But yeah.
All right.
I mean, both of them are incredible. I mean, they've done a lot of. They can act. I mean, they've done a lot of commercials.
Yeah, they definitely have done a lot of commercials. There's one that I see all the time still with Favre and Jerry Rice out there, like throwing the ball around with the back thing, right?
Back supporter.
All right.
Dan Marino with the gloves.
Yep. Yep.
I think they even worked that into Ace Ventura.
Yep.
I'm going to go ahead and tell you my favorite sports film. Let's mentioned it yet, but we did talk about it yesterday. The Bad News Bears.
Yeah, that's really good. Walter Matthau.
Yes.
Tatum O'Neill.
Tatum O'Neill, exactly. Yeah. Like a very young Tatum O'Neill. Doing a fantastic job.
There was a remake with Billy Bob
Thornton. Throwing curveballs when she was like 10, icing down her elbow.
They did do a remake with Billy Bob Thornton. Wasn't as good, but it was decent. So you could see either one. It just seems so groundbreaking for that movie to come out in 1979 with a bunch of kids swearing and stuff on the field. Right,
and then we haven't mentioned The Sandlot yet, which you have to when
The Sandlot
baseball movies, you got to talk about The Sandlot, which I enjoyed a lot, but I wouldn't put in my top five.
Yeah, I mean, when The Bad News Bears came out, that was like that number one movie of the summer of the year and all that kind of stuff. I mean, that was a classic.
Wow,
it had some really good. Even some of the sequels were really good. You know, when they go to the Astrodome.
Well, they went to Japan.
They go to Japan.
Yeah,
The Sandlot, though, I mean that's. It almost just touches that point where it gets you, you know, really sentimental about when you're a kid playing baseball with your buddies.
We'll end with one last one before we go to our third segment, Rocky.
Mm. Yeah, you gotta throw Rocky in there.
I mean, incredible. Mm-hmm. Just still holds up, and they've basically been trying to remake it every time with all the sequels, and then the Creed. Uh-huh. You know,
Rocky IV was pretty darn good. Yeah, pretty darn outstanding. A lot of great boxing movies. Yeah. The Ali movies.
Raging Bull.
Spike Lee. Raging Bull. Yeah. But Spike Lee, We Were Kings. That was Spike Lee, right?
Yeah, I think so.
That was amazing. Yeah. You know, behind the scenes of the Foreman Ali fight.
Yeah.
All right, everyone. That was us just kind of spitballing, going through a plethora of films. All right, we're going to come back with one more segment with Jim Harbaugh. You don't mind sticking around for one more segment, do you, Jim?
Not at all. Okay.
I mean, you're basically living in this house, right?
We'll be quick.
Yeah, we'll be quick. All right, everyone. Thank you. This is the Fandor Podcast.
Thanks for tuning in. Today's show is brought to you by Fandor. Sign up online or in the app for a free one-week trial. Playing now on Fandor is G-Men versus the Dragon. After Japanese spies from the Black Dragon Society infiltrate United States borders, federal agent Rex Bennett is enlisted by the government to capture them. Bennett teams up with British Special Agent Vivian Marsh and Chinese Special Agent Chang Xing to stop them and help win the war. That's Fandor. FANDOR.
the home for cinephiles.